الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. One important benefit that we should reflect upon in the last day of Ramadan with regards to al-istiqamah or being steadfast upon the deen of Allah, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. Worship your Lord till death comes to you. And that's why Al-Hasan Al-Basri rahimahullah, he said, لم يجعل الله سبحانه وتعالى لعمل المؤمن أجل دون الموت. That means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not make for the actions of the believers a limit or an end till death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not make the actions of the believers, did not make an end to it except death. That's the only thing, forgive me for this voice, that prevents the believers from actions. Death. Before death, they are in actions. يَا الْإِنسَانُ إِنَّكَ كَادِحٌ إِلَى رَبِّكَ كَادِحًا فَمُلَاقِيهِ. O mankind, you are working diligently to your Lord and you will see. You will see the effect of your actions. This life is nothing but actions. We are nothing at the end but actions. So where is the limit? Is the moment of death. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَاعْبُدْ رَبَّكَ حَتَّى يَأْتِيَكَ الْيَقِينَ. So the end of Ramadan is not the end, the end of the good deeds. The good deeds is to continue. And that's why, for example, even in the optional acts of worship, there's the 6 days of fasting in Shawwal. 6 days after Ramadan, the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستا من شوال فكأنما صام الدهر. Whoever fast month of Ramadan then follows it with 6 days of شوال as if he fasted the entire year. And the wisdom behind that is that the day is multiplied by 10, so we have 30 days times 10, that's 300. 6 times 10, 60, 360. That if it's only multiplied by 10. And as we heard with fasting, it's beyond the multiplication of the rewards. So this is an authentic hadith from the Prophet ﷺ. And the 6 days of Shawwal, the first day of Shawwal, it's haram to fast. As we mentioned before, you are a abd to Allah, you are a slave of Allah. So you fasted because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَا أُولَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا كُتِبَ عَلَيْكُمُ الصِّيَامُ. And you break your fast because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ordered you to break your fast. So as mentioned yesterday, when inshallah ta'ala, if Allah will, when we witness the Eid, the day of Eid, don't just be in forgetfulness that we're eating because it's Eid. No, you're eating, you're not fasting the day of Eid because it's haram for you to fast. So when you don't fast the day of Eid, you're getting rewards from Allah because you're obeying the orders of Allah. You're not fasting the day of Eid because it's haram. And that's why even for those who have kafara, to fast 2 consecutive months, the day of Eid doesn't count because it's haram to fast. You can start the fasting right after Eid. You can do it consecutively or Mondays and Thursdays or 3 days and then Mondays, Thursdays, whatever there is. Again, this is optional fasting. And we'll talk about the wisdom behind that also and the benefits that are mentioned. But one quick point with this, which is something also very interesting. When we look at the i'tikaf and the essence of al-i'tikaf, for those who made i'tikaf and for us and for those who did not make i'tikaf, to reflect upon the matter of al-i'tikaf or the sense of the last 10 days of Ramadan, the seclusion or the uzla was meant for a person to be secluded from everything, to be focused on the ibadah. The most important focus in the last 10 days of Ramadan especially is the ibadah, nothing else. Fasting during the day and the entire night or most of the night, ibadah and salah. You're not thinking much about provisions and going to work and other things, just the ibadat of the last 10 days of Ramadan. So that takes us to understand that life is not like this. So if a person continue, is that permissible? He would not apply or fulfill the rights in his life. He has rights towards his family, towards his children, towards humanity, whatever there is. So life is not about making i'tikaf in the masjid. It's only at a portion or a few days to gain great benefits, that as if this is what this life is all about. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He did not make us like this. He wants us to be obedient to Him at home, in the market, in your work, in the streets, dealing with the neighbors, dealing with everyone. There are laws and rules to be observed. And that shows who's a true believer versus someone that is follows his desire. If a person would do lots of ibadah every day, what happened after some time? You'll be addicted to it. And a person would love this so much. And this is not what is meant by the deen of Islam, even though it's ibadah, right? But it's meant for a person, and that's why the Prophet ﷺ said, Al-mu'min الذي يخالط الناس, the believer that mixes with people, ويصبر على أذاهم, and he's patient with the harm that might afflict him as a result of that, is better and more beloved to Allah than the mu'min, the one that secludes himself from the people, لا يصبر على أذاهم. So a great benefit that we need now, a person have the means with the ibadah of Allah to be able to face the different trials in one's life with being still obedient to Allah in one's akhlaq, in one's manners, in one's ibadah, to continue with the obligations and so on, and the optional acts of worship and the Quran, portions of the Quran to be recited, dhikr and so on. Another thing is, do you know the months of Hajj? When does the month of Hajj start? Tomorrow. Shawwal. What are the months of Hajj? Shawwal, Dhul Qa'dah, and Dhul Hijjah. So it's right attached to Ramadan. Ibadah, from one ibadah to another ibadah. Right? So once Ramadan is finished, you have Shawwal is one of the months of Hajj. And what does that mean? It means, in extreme, not extreme, if someone goes to Mecca tonight or something like this, and tomorrow the first of Shawwal, he can make the Ihram of Hajj. Because it's one of the months of Hajj. He can make Ihram of Al-Hajj, of Hajj Mufrid. Make only Hajj, not Umrah and Hajj, only Hajj. He can do that. It's valid. And he will stay in his Ihram all the way till he finish the actions of Hajj on the 12th or the 13th of the Hijjah. And he will stay in Ihram Shawwal and Dhul Qa'dah and the first 13 days of Hajj. And believe it or not, some people, I know one person that he did that. This is an extreme where he did not have a family or anything. So after Ramadan finishes, he died, Allah arham, may Allah have mercy on him. After the next day, in Eid, after the day of Eid, he puts his Ihram on and he stays in Ihram till Hajj. Right? And this is not the way of the Prophet ﷺ. This is not something the Sahaba would do. But since it's permissible, that means it's valid for someone to do this. But the point here is not for people to do it, but it's to show that Hajj, the month of Hajj starts. And if a person makes Umrah in Shawwal, someone goes to Mecca and he makes Umrah in Shawwal, and then he relieves himself from the Ihram and he stays in Mecca with his normal clothing, no Ihram, then in the 8th of the Hijjah, he puts the Ihram again, he's making Hajj Tamattu'. Hajj Tamattu' is to make Umrah in the month of Hajj and to stay in the proximity of Mecca. And some of the ulama, they said, it doesn't break the tamattu if you go to Medina and come back. But if you go elsewhere, it breaks the tamattu. And when you come back, you make another Umrah. So Umrah and then Hajj, which is the highest level or the most virtue of matters of Hajj. So this is something also to be observed in the month of Al-Hajj, which is Shawwal, Dhul Qa'dah, Dhul Hijjah. And more, if 200 years ago, those who want to go for Hajj, when do they start their journey if they're far away from Mecca? Right after Ramadan. So they finish Ramadan, they make Eid with their family, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah, they start the journey for Hajj, because it takes a month or more till they reach Mecca. So this is how they used to when it comes to the journey of Hajj. And again, it's only an obligation once in a lifetime. So all of these meanings and more remind us of wa'bud rabbaka hatta ya'tiyaka al-yaqin. Worship your Lord till the moment of death. There's no limit for the deeds of the believers till the moment of death. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us steadfast upon the deen of Allah. And as mentioned before, it's very important in this day, as the early generations of Islam, Salaf al-Salih, they used to spread this among themselves, and Umar ibn al-Aziz would send to all of the provinces to make lots of istighfar. We'll talk about that inshaAllah ta'ala, if Allah will, after Salatul Asr. Wa sallallahu wa sallam, barakah Muhammad wa sahbihi wa sallam.